Well, good morning, everybody. The weather is moving in. And, it was another, excuse me, 15, 16 hour in bed last night. I don't remember what time I actually laid down. But yeah, I know it was like 5, 6 o'clock at the latest. And, so it was a good 16 hours anyway, 17 hours maybe. So, all right, I'm going to make a bowl of cereal, but I just wanted to show you guys one thing. Now this is a good refrigerator. It's an Iceco. I can't remember how big it is. 65 liter maybe. Anyways, if you can get a upright fridge, every time you take something out, you've got to take it. I mean, I don't have a lot in there right now, but when it's even close to half full, or you know, kind of full, every time you take something out, five things fall into, or that one, it's just a pain in the butt, guys. Hold on a second there. Little Sunny D. But, you know, the cheese wants to fall in there. Everything wants to fall in there. My soda, you got to move out of the way. Get the berries. Milk. Luckily, there's not, like I said, there's not a lot of stuff in there right now. So, everything's not falling in. Get our bowl. Our little pantry down here. I want to say, you guys gave me some really good ideas about trying to register a new vehicle. I thought of some of them. Like, you know, renting a place, a hotel. Problem is, where I am, basically everything's full up. If it's not full up, it's expensiver than heck. I checked on a couple hotels the other day. None of them were extended stays. They looked like it, but they were like $75 a night. So, you know, you're looking, you know, $500 a week. So, yeah, that's, I haven't found one. I thought I saw one the other day, but it's full up. And that's the problem. There's so many people that can't afford the higher priced apartments anymore. That's why everybody's living in a van or in a tent, or, you know, I mean, obviously there are other reasons why a lot of people are having issues or have issues, not only, you know, mental or drug use or alcohol use, or, you know, anything can put you out of a house. So what I'm going to do today is I'm just going to eat my cereal. Excuse me. I'm going to get on the internet, look at some employment possibilities, I think. Sometimes there's weird noises. I don't know if you could hear it. It was just right underneath me. But look for some employment possibilities, maybe, and then try to look around for a place a little better. But the other good idea was the homeless. You know, get some help from the homeless. Because I know if one of the agencies fills out a form for you, you can get a driver's license. So maybe that's in the same case of registering a vehicle. So unfortunately, it's Friday. So I'm not going into town today, like I said. Trying to keep as few miles on the bean pot as possible. Some people said I should get a second opinion or just fix it. Well, if I fix a transmission, where am I going to stay for a week, you know? Then it's, again, this is too small for this area. The moisture in the Pacific Northwest, I can't be outside as much. And if I'm going to be working and living out of a van, well, you know, going to work, living out of the van or SUV, I really need to get it bigger, a little more room. So, all right, guys, I'm going to eat my cereal, a little blueberries in there, and then I'm going to get to work on the computer. So if anything happens today, we will show you, and definitely when we go into town and start trying to look around for places and whatnot, we will bring you along with us. So for right now, we'll talk to you a little later. Well, alrighty, everybody. It's official. I am sick. I knew I was coming down with something, because, I mean, you don't just lay in bed for that many hours straight, day after day. But last night, I actually started getting sick. I don't really feel horrible, but I did get physically sick last night a couple times. Kind of a little stuffy, it's a little head stuff, you know what I mean? Other than that, I don't feel horrible. I'm extremely, extremely tired. So, all right, we got a week of cold weather coming up. The highs are only going to be in the low 50s, and the lows are going to be in the high 20s. For the next 7 days, and there's chances of rain, snow, most of those days. So we're going to go to town, get rid of my garbage, get some supplies to at least last maybe, I don't know, 4 or 5 days. Milk, cereal. You know, I have 2 propane canisters. I may get 2 more. 2 should last me, 2.5 really, should last me the 5 days. But we'll see. And just some odds and ends. And then we're going to try to find somewhere to get a good meal. All I've seen is fast food joints. But at least if I could find maybe a Popeyes or a KFC, at least I'd get a, you know, kind of a better meal than Taco Bell and McDonald's, those kind of places. So, all right, let's head to town and get some supplies and go find ourselves a place to eat. See, this really isn't much camping at all out here. There's only just a couple of hidey spots. All right, let's get to town. What was I thinking? Today's Saturday. Walmart's packed. Gotta do it. Well, I made it through Wally World unscathed. Got back to the car and forgot the propane. Had to go back in. Propane took almost as long as the entire shopping sequence. So, all right, let's go get dinner. Yeah, I tried a mac and cheese bowl. Spicy chicken sandwich, hopefully for later on. But all right, it's cold, it's windy. Keeps looking like it wants to rain out here. Like I said, it's going to be, I mean, it's 50 degrees out right now. It's 3 o'clock. But it's going to be basically 50 to 28 the next week. So, all right, the neighbor came over the other day and he looked all sad and he told me they were moving. I asked him where. He told me, I was like, I wouldn't want to go there, but. He told me he was a victim of the I-5 killer. So I just looked up the I-5 killer. The guy was in 80 and 81, it said on the internet. This guy's 39 years old. Yeah. So, guess that was, you know, he's full of garbage. But I was supposed to move. They were still there when I left today. I'm hoping they move because I'd like to take the spot. But we may drive around a little bit further around and see if we can't find a better spot. It's not bad where I am. Just would like something a little better. So, all right, let's go for a drive. See what we can find. All right, we're pulling up on another camping area here. And I'll tell you right now, there's no way in heck. But I'm going to turn around here so you can see what I'm looking at. So we have this over here. As you see, they just treat it as a dump. Throw everything right outside your trailer. Let it pile up. Yeah. And you got the neighborhood over here. And then actually a dump. And then another crappy neighborhood over there. Yeah, this is definitely nowhere we want to stay. Or even be around. You know, that just... I mean, that over there is a little nicer. At least it looks like they're trying to keep it halfway built up and make their own little homesteads. But, wow. Some more trashed areas. That's why people don't let you camp on public land when you treat it like that. All right, let's head back to our camp. All right, so I pulled into another area. And, I mean, it's everything. It's just like this. People are just pulling in here, dumping their garbage. And then they go back into a little further, and there's some trailers back there. I'm just trying to find a decent spot to turn around. I'm not going back there. I mean, this is just pure trash. You know it's those people right there doing it. I mean, the road's horrible too. Man, why do that? Public land like this. Yeah, we're gonna definitely get out of here, but I mean, this one may have a little, you know, you could probably find some spot way back in there, but the road's horrible as it is. And yeah, I definitely don't think so. But yeah, everywhere you see it here is trash. The road's completely messed up too. It's baby strollers, beds, who knows what else. Ugh. Yeah, we're going back to our little hidey hole. None of these places are anything I want to be around. I mean, look at this, just more trash everywhere you look. Dump everything right alongside the Forest Service roads. And glass all over the place. Jesus. Yeah. Alright. Back to our place. All right, everybody. So we changed spots. This one is much more secluded. Got a little bit of garbage. I don't see that back there. Tires, some little like lattice stuff. There's a couple tires on the other side. Yeah, I wish people hadn't have done that. But where I went, moved to, is there's really nothing around me. It's just a place off the middle of nowhere. So obviously, you know, this little spot people have used it as a dump. You know, I don't know why people have to do that on public land. But the only problem is the ground. See how, if you can see that. I mean, it's really fluffy and soft. If it rains hard, I could get stuck in this stuff. Especially with my tranny the way it is. I don't want it to spin. I mean, I think if I just went slow, just put it basically in gear and let go, I think it would roll me out of here. If I back up to where there's a little bit of grass and it's still fluffy and soft, but I'd still have to go through that stuff. And I think we're going to try it here for at least a night or two. See what it is. It's windier here, though. probably windy at my other spot too. I just, you know, but I just noticed it here today. So, all right, we're going to go ahead and get the bean pod ready and then probably head to bed, or well, into bed, because like I said, I don't feel good. And it's about 5 o'clock now. So I'll probably be getting in there. All right, guys, we'll see you. We'll tell you in the morning what I think about the spot. Well, good morning, everybody. So, it tried to spit and sputter off and on last night, but it really never rained. Got extremely cold out. I keep forgetting to buy one of those indoor-outdoor thermometers, so I know exactly how cold it is outside. But my phone said it was 26 degrees last night in town. It was definitely every bit of that. It was cold out. I had the Mr. Buddy going as well as the flower pot. Kept it relatively warm in here. As soon as the flower pot and the Mr. Buddy went out last night, I woke up at like 1:30 and it was like 51 degrees in here. Changed out the tank, relit the flower pot, got back up into the 60s. And I basically kept it in the 60s all night. So it wasn't bad here in the bean pot at all. The spot, very quiet. And I feel a lot safer here. I did not wake up to shooting this morning. Other than a little bit of garbage that's around here, I wish I could get rid of it. But what am I going to do with tires? I can't. No way I can put them to take them anywhere. So unfortunately, it got to stay here. Other than that, I think I'm going to go ahead and try to get this video out so you guys have something to hear what's going on. I feel better today. I didn't sleep as long last night, or I got out of bed anyways. I was able to reheat chicken last night, ate more of it this morning for breakfast, didn't get sick, so that's a win. But other than that, I don't think I'm doing anything today anyways. Tomorrow we will attempt to go find another mailbox that may be able to be used for registration. The van that I was thinking about buying has come down $2,500. That tells me she really wants to get rid of it, or there's really something wrong with it for her to drop it $2,500 in a week. She may have put it out there a lot more than she bought it for, and you know, and I was just hoping, but I think it's probably registered commercial, which I would also have to find out how bad that would adjust the rates. I know if it was registered as an RV, it would be much cheaper, but there's been nothing done with it. I said the floor is insulated and has carpet. I don't know if they did that or it was already like that. The pictures all look good. So tomorrow we are going to go in and talk to the DMV folks, and we'll talk to the postal service that a subscriber recommended. I had seen the one they were talking about. I don't know why I tried UPS. I just figured, you know, I had heard UPS you could use. So we'll do that. We'll check with the DMV maybe. We'll see after what the postal place service tells me and go from there. But yeah, I think I'm just going to lay inside anyways today. It's only going to be 50 out. I mean, it's nice and pretty right now. Said it was going to rain today. There's always a noise in here, I swear. Said it was going to rain. It's beautiful out right now. Partly cloudy at least, at most. But it's very cold. It's only 40 degrees out. It's already new, and I've been watching videos and Netflix and eating. So, yeah, I'm going to just hang out in here. So, as always, you guys, thank you for watching, subscribing, commenting, sharing, liking, sharing, all that good stuff. I appreciate it. And as always, have a good evening, afternoon, morning, wherever you are. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time on Jelly Bean Outdoors.